Hey all, welcome to Share Trek. This is Raj here, and today along with me is my trusted buddy Corey. She's going to co-host with me because she's feeling very anxious and she wants to be next to me until I finish this video, so I hope you can bear with that. And let me talk about the topic we have today. I want to share details from an article that appeared a couple of days ago in the AIDS Map website. It has really interesting findings regarding mortality rates among people living with HIV in North America and Europe. It's a bit of a mixed bag. And of course, this is more relevant to the developed world than the underdeveloped world. So let's dive in. Welcome back, friends. Before we start the topic, I have an important announcement to make. This Saturday, the 6th of April at 10 a.m. Eastern Time, I will have a Zoom call with the members of the channel. It will be an interactive chat and will not be recorded. It's the first meeting we'll have, and I think we'll have multiple languages, and I will try to get a sense of how to organize future meetings for best outcome. So in our channel, we have the post section. So please check out my latest members only post for the Zoom invitation. So you'll have a link out there. You'll have the meeting ID and the meeting passcode. Please do not share it with anyone. It's just for the members at this point of time. And let us see how we can get this going. That said, let's go on to the main topic. This will be of interest to those from developed nations with high per capita income. Before 1996, the outlook for people with HIV was pretty grim. Death from AIDS was almost a certainty, even in wealthier countries. But then something game-changing happened. Combination antiretroviral therapy came into scene. This therapy was super effective at suppressing HIV, and as a result, AIDS-related deaths dropped dramatically, especially in Europe and North America. But here's the thing. Between 1996 and 2012, ART wasn't always started right away. It used to be that treatment began only when a person's CD4 count fell below a certain level or if they showed symptoms. That all changed after some solid research showed that starting ART immediately, regardless of CD4 count, was the best approach. So between 2012 and 2015, there was a big push globally to get people on treatment as soon as they were diagnosed. Nowadays, thanks to effective treatment, people with HIV are living longer. That's great news, right? Well, mostly. While deaths from AIDS have gone down, other causes of death are still a concern. Substance use and hepatitis C are still taking a toll. And now people with HIV are more likely to die from things like heart disease or cancer as they get old, like the rest of us. So what did the researchers find? They looked at data from 17 HIV cohorts in Europe and North America, covering over 189,000 people with HIV who started ART between 1996 and 2020. Over this period, they found that the average age of people with HIV increased, which makes sense given that treatment is helping people live longer. Now let's talk about numbers. Between 1996 and 2020, AIDS-related deaths dropped by a whooping 33% and overall death rates decreased too, from 17.1 deaths per 1,000 people between 2000 and 2003 to just 7.9 deaths per 1,000 people between 2016 and 2010. And that's a significant improvement. But there is still some concerning trends. For example, while death rates for gay and bisexual men have gone down, women who inject drugs are still facing challenges. Their death rates actually increased by 7%, which is definitely not good news. And when it comes to substance use related deaths, things are looking better in Europe, but not so much in North America, where the opioid crisis is still a major issue. Overall, it's a mixed bag. While there's been a huge improvement in survival rates for people with HIV, there are still some challenges to overcome, especially for certain groups like women who inject drugs. But hey, progress is progress. And what is more, if you had seen my recent video, I had shared information on a new initiative in the US that found that infants put on ART within 48 hours of birth have a chance to achieve sustained remission. This means we are still working on improving the odds of survival. So what are your thoughts on these findings? Let me know in the comment section below. And friends, please consider becoming a member of the channel so that you can join me in the Zoom call. And we'll be talking about whatever videos we publish out here. And we'll also have a Q&A session. And those Zoom calls could give us idea for new videos as well and enrich your experience. So with that, my friends, I would like to bring this video to an end, and I'll catch up with you again in the next video next week. But wait, I'll be talking to you again in an interactive manner on Saturday. So see you on Saturday. Bye.